Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video describes the discovery of BMS-986176, also called LX9211. This compound inhibits AAK1 and is in development as a treatment for neuropathic pain. The video reports the discovery program of BMS-986176 as described in a Drug Annotations article in the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry by scientists at Bristol Myers Squibb in both Connecticut and New Jersey, Lexicon Pharmaceuticals in Texas, and Biocon BMS in Bangalore, India. The citation is at the bottom of the screen, and a link to the article can be found in the video description. This video is not an exhaustive discussion of the article. I have selected what I consider to be the research highlights that best summarize the project. Let's start with defining neuropathic pain. Neuropathic pain arises when the body generates flawed or maladaptive responses in the nervous system because of damage to connections between the somatosensory system and the central nervous system in the brain and/or spinal column. Neuropathic pain affects between 7 and 10% of the population. Many current drugs have low efficacy or adverse drug reactions. Therefore, neuropathic pain represents an unmet medical need. Researchers have found that AAK1, that is, adaptor protein 2 associated kinase 1, is a recognized target for the treatment of neuropathic pain. AAK1 was discovered through a mouse knockout model and a considerable amount of experimentation. Fortunately, because of this research, the literature now contains reports of both tool compounds with AAK1 activity and assays for testing AAK1 binding, inhibition, as well as in vivo activity. AAK1 appears to be a druggable target for treating neuropathic pain. The Drug Annotations article begins not with a high-throughput screening campaign, but with a description of a compound that was previously discovered by Bristol Myers Squibb and Lexicon. That compound, which is on the slide and has been reported in the literature, is a potent inhibitor of AAK1. It shows good CNS penetration, reduces phosphorylation in vivo, and is well tolerated in animal models when administered subcutaneously. As part of the research program around this molecule, the scientists were also able to prepare co-crystals of similar compounds with AAK1. So the structure to the left, which is the same as the previous structure, except it is missing 2 fluorine atoms on the O-methyl, does form X-ray quality co-crystals with AAK1. Here is a screen capture from the protein databank of the X-ray structure, PDB entry 7LVH. The inhibitor has the darker gray scaffold. The dotted lines indicate interactions such as hydrophobic and hydrogen bonding. Through co-crystals such as this one, the nature of inhibitor engagement with AAK1 has been well characterized and sets the stage for further optimization of compounds in this series. The goal of the current Drug Annotations article is therefore to start with the known AAK1 inhibitor that is administered subcutaneously and optimize the structure to improve potency, further boost CNS penetration, and raise oral absorption. For the early stages of the optimization program, 4 criteria guided the selection of new compounds to be advanced as leads. The first criterion was the potency of compounds as determined in a biochemical enzyme inhibition assay in the form of an IC50 value. Second was the equilibrium binding as a Ki value in a radio-labeled displacement assay. Next, researchers measured the inhibition of cellular phosphorylation of Mu2, which is the protein that is phosphorylated by AAK1. So this cellular assay is a secondary confirmation of biochemical inhibition. Finally, the earlier compounds carried concerns of inhibition of the 3A4 isoform of cytochrome P450, and the discovery team wanted to minimize this risk of possible drug-drug interactions. Structurally, the oxazole ring was suspected to be a key player in the 3A4 inhibition, so changes to that ring were anticipated. As was mentioned on the previous slide, raising bioavailability was a goal. The amide group was believed to be reducing oral absorption, so the amide needs to go as well. Here are a few early compounds that were explored. Note that the oxazole has been replaced with a pyridine ring. The amide has been replaced with an ether. The unsubstituted compound, compound 8, loses a lot of potency with an IC50 against AAK1 of 49 nanomolar relative to an IC50 of 12 nanomolar in the original compound. The potency can be restored and even markedly improved with the addition of small R groups, especially electron withdrawing groups around the core scaffold. Target binding and cellular potency were also improved. With compounds 14, 18, and 19, inhibition of 3A4 was reduced to around 20 micromolar, which was promising. Based on these results, compounds 18 and 19 were studied for their ADME and preliminary safety properties. Here we have 18 and 19 in the upper right. The only difference is a single fluorine atom. Note that these compounds have similar biochemical potencies, while 19 is nearly tenfold more potent in the cellular assay. The cellular assay does include serum proteins, so the compounds will be subject to plasma protein binding. Compound 19 has a much larger unbound fraction than 18, and according to the free drug hypothesis, the larger unbound fraction of 18 could be linked to its increased potency in the cellular assay, as noted by the authors. The compounds show reasonable metabolic stability. Membrane permeability testing in a KCO2 assay indicates reasonable membrane permeability and low affinity with efflux transporters. The last two lines of this table are early safety assays. The aortic ring assay measures vasodilation and was implemented because of some of the subcutaneous AAK1 inhibitors were linked to loss of blood pressure and heart rate in vivo. While 18 was not tested, compound 19 showed a high percentage of relaxation in the assay. Compound 19 was also less selective for AAK1 than 18 when tested against a panel of other kinases. This finding indicates a possible higher safety liability in 19. Based on these data, compound 18 was selected for further study. Compound 18 was tested in a chemically induced diabetic peripheral neuropathic pain rat model. So, these data were obtained in rats showing symptoms of neuropathic pain. The study tested the force required to cause an animal to withdraw its paw following oral administration of compound 18. The study included four cohorts. The group at the bottom of the table is for untreated diseased animals, which pulled away their paw after being subjected to 31 grams of force. The cohort that was treated with 1 mg per kg of 18 tolerated 36 grams of force, indicated more pain tolerance. A cohort of animals that had been dosed with a known neuropathic pain compound at a high dose of 30 mg per kg tolerated a 41 gram force. Finally, healthy, non-diseased animals tolerated 47 grams of force before pulling away their paws. So, compound 18 is showing modest efficacy at 3.5 hours following an oral dose of 1 mg per kg. The researchers noted that at 5.5 hours after an oral dose, compound 18 was highly concentrated in the brain and spine relative to the plasma. The site of action for 18 is the spine, so this is a favorable finding. While the results for 18 serve as a proof of concept of activity through oral delivery, further optimization was required for the project to achieve its goals. The chemist went back into lab and prepared additional analogs. Here are 27 and 34. Compound 27 is an example from the 3-pyridyl series, and 34 is from the 2-pyridyl series. Multiple compounds from both series were prepared. 34 was more potent and showed much improved permeability over compounds 18 and 19. More importantly, compound 34 displayed less relaxation in the aortic ring assay, an indication of reduced potential cardiovascular toxicity. Additional preclinical safety studies on 34 revealed low risk of CYP inhibition and therefore low risk for certain types of drug-drug interactions. Compound 34 showed reasonably high inhibition in the Herge patch clamp assay. Normally an IC50 of 1.4 micromolar in this assay would be a cause for high concern, but the tendency for these compounds to concentrate within the central nervous system minimizes Herge risk. Compound 34 also gave favorable results for transporter inhibition, low activity against common high-risk toxicity targets, and low mutagenicity. To test in vivo activity, compound 34 was used in two studies. The first is the previously mentioned chemically induced disease model in rats, the DPNP model. Note that increasing doses of 34 allow the animals to tolerate higher levels of force before withdrawing a paw. In the second model, rats with surgically induced neuropathy were studied for the time required to withdraw their paw from a heat stimulus. This is the CCI model. Again, compound 34 showed a dose-response relationship in the response times. At the highest dose of 34, 1 mg per kg, the response times were very comparable to the established positive control at a very high dose, as well as healthy rats. These are promising data. A risk for any compound that reduces neuropathic pain is that the compound will also reduce motor control and coordination. Causing loss of motor control could affect patient tolerability. Therefore, compound 34 was studied in the chemically induced rat neuropathy model, the DPNP model. 3 hours after dosing with compound 34, rats were allowed to ride a rotating rod. Shorter ride times indicate less coordination, an undesirable outcome for a drug. Untreated rats were able to ride and balance on the rod for approximately 290 seconds. Cohorts treated with 34 at relatively high doses showed moderately reduced ride times. Animals treated with the control compound, a known neuropathy therapy, and the same control used in the other studies in this discussion, showed markedly reduced ride times. Compound 34 therefore appears to have less of an impact on motor control relative to the control compound. We touched upon the tendency of these compounds to concentrate in the brain and spinal column earlier. This slide highlights this tendency. In the first column, we see the size of an oral dose. 3 hours after the dose, approximate plasma concentration increases with dose, while spinal concentration is consistently considerably higher. The percent occupancy of the target AAK1 at the spinal concentrations was experimentally determined. Based on this study, at relatively low plasma concentrations, high spinal concentrations of 34 could be achieved, along with potentially high levels of target occupancy. The tendency of 34 and related compounds to concentrate in the central nervous system helps reduce safety risks arising from uniform systemic exposure. Here we have some key PK parameters in preclinical species. These parameters were determined through a combination of IV and oral doses. None of these values is particularly notable. Half-lives across the species are reasonable for an orally dosed drug. Bioavailability, a key area of concern at the outset of this discovery campaign, is favorable in the rat and dog, but rather low in the monkey. With a favorable safety profile and reasonable evidence for efficacy and PK behavior, the discovery team received authorization to initiate clinical trials. To date, BMS-986176, or LX9211, the same as compound 34, has completed phase 1 trials and did not show any serious drug-related adverse events. The compound is currently in phase 2 trials for two indications: diabetic, peripheral, neuropathic pain, and postherpetic neuralgia. The clinicaltrials.gov identifiers are shown on this slide. Lexicon Pharmaceuticals is on record as a sponsor for both trials, which are ongoing without posted results at the time of the recording of this video. Thank you so much for watching to the end of this drug discovery story on BMS-986176 or LX9211. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.